This morning, Queensland authorities hit the big red button.
Any delay could see significant, if not catastrophic, results. This is not hypothetical.
The snap three-day lockdown applies to Brisbane, Logan, Ipswich, Moreton Bay and Redlands, home to more than 2.2 million people. The stay-at-home order carries 9 exceptions, including exercise, essential work, shopping for necessities and providing care, with masks made mandatory outside the home.
Look at it as a long weekend at home with your family and friends.
All because of a single infection.
This UK strain is 70% more infectious. And we are going to go hard and we are going to go early to do everything we can to stop the spread of this virus.
WA, of course, slammed their borders shut, with most of the Federation imposing more mild isolation requirements. New South Wales resisting the temptation to go tit for tat with its northern neighbour.
If you've visited Brisbane and you're on your way to New South Wales, those isolation rules will apply to you.
But the new strain's already causing concern beyond Brisbane, with another case popping up in WA hotel quarantine and 6 detected in New South Wales hotel quarantine. In fact, it was enough to get the band back together. National Cabinet reconvening to declare, for only the second time, a federal hotspot.
If you are from any of those places and you are somewhere else, you should treat yourself as if you are in those places.
For overseas Aussies trying to escape the new strain running rampant abroad, bad news. The cap on international arrivals will be reduced by 50% in Queensland, WA and New South Wales until mid-February. And to even make it that far, travellers must return a negative test before boarding a flight.
It moves so quickly, far more quickly than previous strains of the virus.
Staying on the National Cabinet meeting today, all the state premiers were working very hard on how to deal with the UK mutant strain. And Victorian Premier Daniel Andrews was keen to push his idea of pre-flight testing. And I bet if it got through, he couldn't wait to claim the credit.
About to have a National Cabinet meeting, and I'm very pleased to say that it's my expectation. I'm very confident that we will see issues like pre-flight testing, a whole range of measures that we've pushed and advocated for.
I'm very pleased to announce that our suggestion from South Australia that pre-flight testing come into place has been agreed to.
Oh, well, I hate to break it to you, gentlemen, but it was actually my idea. You know, both of those men are wearing glasses, and I bet you anything, only one of them needs it and the other one's copying.
Well, epidemiologist Professor Tony Blakely joins us from sunny Budrum in Queensland. Tony, it's such a decisive response today. I'm not sure a single case has triggered a lockdown until now. Is it possible that they're going overboard?
No, emphatically no. This is a highly contagious variant of the virus. It's 50 to 70% more contagious or transmissible. We don't want it in our community. This is something where you go hard, you go early and stamp it out if Australia wants to maintain largely zero transmission. So no, it's not an overreaction.
Well, if this strain is as contagious as feared, then will 3 days be enough to squash an outbreak?
Not if it's a full-blown outbreak, but 3 days is enough for the contact tracing to happen and see how many cases are there. And maybe we'll be lucky and there'll be no additional cases and we'll look sweet again from 3 days' time. If there's lots of cases popping up, then probably some form of restriction will need to continue. Whether it's a hard lockdown or something less, time will tell.
Tony, you're just visiting Budrum. Is 3 days enough because you want to go home?
Well, actually, we've been looking very closely at this. I've been watching the airline flights on Sunday, and I think we'll sneak into Victoria before anything too dire happens.
There seems to be serious concerns that our current quarantine protocols just aren't tight enough, I suppose, to contain this new strain. In your view, are our systems up to scratch?
OK, there's a bit of a longer answer on this one. Everything about COVID is risk reduction, reduce. And I'm actually going to give full marks to the states and territories and federal government response today. They've done pretty much everything. Testing before people get on the plane reduces it. Masks on the plane. Testing when they arrive at the airport. and then improve quarantine, and importantly, what myself and others have been advocating for, vaccinating all the border and quarantine staff. All those measures together will tighten the border. It will never be perfect. So hopefully this will reduce the occurrence of leakage out of quarantine from once per month somewhere in Australia to something like once every 3 months. And then if that happens again, we'll see exactly what we're seeing in Greater Brisbane now, the tough lockdown to complement the quarantine. There's one more thing I would recommend at this point in time, or two actually. One is that when they get on the plane in the UK, they've been tested 2 days before with the high quality test, testing them at the airport as well, because they could have caught it in 2 days would be a good idea. And I think it's time we had independent monitoring of quarantine with a three-person group of an epidemiologist, public health nurse, infectious disease expert, just going around all these sites and reporting on how well they're doing on process. It's that important.
Tony, really appreciate your insights. Thanks so much for your time.
My pleasure.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.